guys, welcome back to Ra's Catering. My name's Jason Ra, and today what we've got on the menu for you is absolutely lovely, delicious. It is a spiced mango and pineapple crumble. Absolutely beautiful, very tasty. Let's go. Right, so we've got a nice, make sure we're nice and sharp. And then we can cut through our pineapple, yeah? We use half of our pineapple. We'll take off the outer skin. Sliding all over the place. There we go. Take off the bottom. And what we do, we'll cut it in half again. We'll take out this core. Just neaten it up. We don't want the core. We'll cut it into chunks. We don't want the chunks too small. We don't want them too big. We want them about bite size. So about that size, perfect. There's our pineapple. Okay, so now we're gonna start to slice the skin off our mango. Take off the top, take off the bottom, and then we just want to go on the skin, as close to the skin as possible, and just slicing it down. Try and get a ripe mango, as ripe as possible. The greener, the better. So as we say, we're trying to cut as close to the seed as possible. Try not to get any of the seed in there. There we go. One last bit. That's it. That's our mango. And now we can cut it up into chunks. As I say, you don't have to be arty-farty about it. Just cut it up really rustic, really rough, and that's it. As long as it's cut up, that's the, can't ask for more. That's it, so that's done. So now for our marinade. So we get a little pot. So in our pot, we've got our pineapple. And then we're gonna add our mango. So we've got our pineapple and mango in there. Okay, so we've got our ground nutmeg. One about a teaspoon. And then we have our ground allspice, also a teaspoon. And we want to mix it around. So make sure it's coating all of the pineapple and the mango. That's it. Lovely, and then we'll wash our hands. Alright, so with our mix, we're going to put in some brown sugar, light brown sugar. We'll put in about a quarter of a cup. We will get that mixed around as well. Alright, so make sure everything is coated. So when the sugar is cooking out, it's making like a caramel sauce of caramel infusion of mango and pineapple and all the spices together. Sounds lovely. Okay, so now we're going to be getting our bowls. This is what we're going to make our crumble in. Okay, so we'll grab our spoon and then we'll start bowling these up. Kind of want equal portions. You don't want to give someone more than the other and they're sitting right next to you. And then they look in your plate and say, oh, why have you got more than me? Maybe the chef doesn't like me. So there we go, we'll get this bowled up. There we go. So, that's the base of our crumble, mango and pineapple.
Lovely.
So now what we can do, we can get starting our topping of the crumble. Let's go. Okay, so now for our crumble topping. We've got about 150 grams of butter, straight in. So now we've got our butter in, so we can add our flour. So we want to start off with, say, about 4 spoons of flour. Yeah. Right, so now we've got our flour in, so what we're going to do, we're going to mix the flour and the butter together using our fingertips. They say using your fingertips is the best way because it's the hottest part of our body. So, and it melts the butter faster. So we'll mix that in. If you need more flour, it's always good to add. Remember, you can add, but you can't take away, okay? So we'll get that mixed in. All right, so now our butter and our flour is mixed together. It's almost like a paste consistency. So then I'm gonna add my sugar and my oats into it. There we go, adding our sugar. So our sugar, 4 spoons. Okay, so now our sugar's in, and I'm gonna go for 4 spoons of my oats. Just to start off with, if I need more, I can always add more. But it's better to start with less, and then add more when you need. Because if you start with more, you can't exactly take it out, can you? So, start mixing that up together. Another 2 spoons of oats. And we'll just mix that around, keep going. So we want that crumbly, crumbly consistency. A few more oats. So you don't want it too dry. So that would be horrible. So if the oats, add about another 3 spoons. Keep mixing until we get this consistency. Then what we'll do with our hands, we'll rub it together. So it just falls apart. All right, so we're at the perfect consistency. So what we want to do is add in our desiccated coconut. We're adding about 500 grams. Perfect, because we want to taste the coconut as well. We want to have every element shining through, pinging off your taste buds. So with the coconut, we're going to add in about 150 grams. Don't be shy with it. There we go. And mix that up in the crumble. This can go in your fridge, in your freezer, and you can just keep it there. It doesn't need to be thrown away. That's why I've made a lot, just to show you that it doesn't need to be thrown away. Okay, so now we've got our base ready, we've got our topping ready, so all we need to do now is just top the base. So, let's go. Just sprinkling it all over. As I said, don't be shy with it. So I think a lot of people would like this crumble as well. It's a different kind of crumble, it's not your bog standard crumble. Lovely. And on top of that, I'll just put a light dusting of brown sugar. Just to give it that little glaze in the oven. So there we've got our dusting of brown sugar on the top. So it'll give it a nice light glaze. Okay, so now that's done. So we'll pop these in the oven at 180 for about 15 minutes. Keep an eye on it, because once again, you want the crumble to be golden brown.
That's it, perfect.
Let's go. 180, in the oven, 15 minutes, job done. So we've got our mango pineapple crumble, and then top a drizzle of cream. So there we have it, guys. We got our spiced mango and pineapple crumble. And if you missed out on any of the ingredients, you can check it on our website, www.rascatering.co.uk. Enjoy, guys.